Hi folks, Larry here, Mobile Tech with CanhamTrailers.com. Here in my new shop, right next to the 66 Super Shasta. And I wanted to give you an update on what's going on with this trailer, with my YouTube channel, with my camera situation, all that good stuff, because I'm working again and I got the shop all set up and I bought some more photography equipment so I can make better videos for you people. So first let's go to the Shasta and talk about what I've been doing here. Yesterday I went ahead and I cut all the window holes out. And if you've been watching my videos, you know that I like to use a router. Well, I used to like using a router. And even though I found the proper bits for it, the bits and pieces that come off the metal, the waste, gets caught between the router table and the side of the skin. And that's okay, it scratches, see, it scratches the paint. And that's okay if you're going to repaint the entire trailer. But if you're just going to use the basic white, the polar white that comes on the metal skin that you buy new from Steve Loomis over there at Hemet Valley RV and Siding, if you do that, those scratches you're going to have to touch up. And I'll show you the kind of scratches that it makes here in a minute. So what I did was I decided to go ahead and try out using my electric shears that I got from Harbor Freight for 50 bucks, and that worked great. I actually tried to make a video of that, a short how-to video, trailer tidbit, quick tip, but it didn't work out very well because I was still getting used to this camera and the focus and all that stuff. So that video didn't happen. But basically all I did was I drilled little 1/8 inch holes in the corners from the inside and then took a straight edge and a blue marking pen and I made marks all the way around here to show my border. And then I drilled a 1/2 inch hole in 3 of the corners, this one, the upper one, and the one over here. You don't need 4, because you're going to end up in the top corner here. Let me get the whole window in here. There you go. All right, so I drilled a 1/2 inch hole here, here, and here. And you don't need one up here. That's to get the jaws of the shears in to where they'll cut. And then I just cut it out and followed the lines. It worked really easy. I was really happy with it. So that's the way I'm gonna do it from now on. It doesn't scratch up the metal. And like I say, I'll show you that in a minute. So this trailer is going to have to get touched up when I go to paint the stripes on it. We're still going to use the base coat as the primary color because the whole trailer is white. But I'm going to have to touch up everywhere that got scratched, and that's mostly the perimeter on both sides and around the door. So I didn't use the router in the back or in the front, so I don't have to worry about that. So let's start with cameras now. Oh, wait a minute. Let me go ahead and show you that. All right. See if you can see. I think you can see that. See the scratches? That's what it does. And so I'm going to have to touch all that up. It's all the way around the perimeter, the back, the top. And I haven't cut the wheel wells out yet, so I don't have to worry about there, but it won't take that long, but yeah, that's what I'm gonna have to do. All right. Now you know where my saying comes from. I make mistakes so you don't have to. That's my job. I go out and make the mistakes. I put them on video, and then you can circumvent those problems by watching my videos. All right, that brings us to cameras. What I'm shooting now with is my new Canon T5i. It's a DSLR, and it's a really nice camera. Pretty expensive, but it's the bottom of the DSLRs, I guess, price-wise. And what I'm finding out about these cameras is the camera body itself normally doesn't cost too much. compared to the lenses. I could spend thousands on lenses. I could spend $10,000 on lenses, and the camera itself is only about $800 with the package that it comes with. So I'll show you that in a minute. I also bought this point and shoot. Now, I've been using one of these for the last 3 years, and you need an automatic point and shoot that you can carry in your pocket for the things that I do. You can't always be setting up that great big camera with the boom mic and everything. For little things and for my travels, my exploring videos and so forth, you need one of these too. And these are great. These run with the kits that you buy with them and everything. This runs about $230 plus extra batteries and carrying case and all that stuff. So the old one that I had still works great. There's nothing wrong with it except for one thing. I think you've noticed in my previous videos lately that whenever I point into the sun or light, that there's a lot of dust. And you go, Larry, why don't you clean that dust off? It's on the inside of the lens. That's the problem. So as a result, you have to send it in to be cleaned. They have to take the camera apart, and it costs almost as much as buying a new one. So I just said, heck with it, I'm gonna buy a new one. So I bought this one, and here it is. And what I'm gonna do with it right now is I'm going to shoot that camera so that you can see my big camera, my new big Canon. So let me go ahead and shoot that now. Here it is. There's my T5i. Isn't that nice? I mean, yeah, I got the dead cat for the boom mic. And the thing I really like about this, as you can see, when I'm shooting, I can turn this thing flips. Look at. There it is. So I bought these cameras to make better videos for you people. So I'm investing in you. I'm investing in myself. I'm investing in my channel and my website. All right. So that brings us to one more little bit of news. Let me turn this off. And I can just shove this in my pocket. I have joined up with Patreon. If you don't know what Patreon is, it's a new system out in which you can join up and receive extra benefits from my YouTube channel. And you do this by pledging donations, okay? Which is, your donations is how I buy these cameras and all the related equipment. I also bought a new editing program, Adobe Premiere, which I didn't want to pay the subscription, which is you have to pay monthly on that. So I bought an earlier version, Elements 14, to learn how to use it. And then probably later on I'll go to Pro and pay the monthly subscription. But I want to see how things go, because this all comes out of my pocket. The cameras come out of my pocket. I have very expensive internet here. That's $70 a month for the minimum. And that's going to have to go up, because one of the benefits that you're going to get by becoming a Patreon is you'll be able to view live streaming video from my shop. Excuse me. And you'll be able to chat with me while viewing, and I'll be able to answer questions for you and show you right there live while you're watching how to do something. And whether it's on a trailer regarding tools, materials, or whatever. So that's going to be one of the extra benefits that you have from being a patron on my Patreon system. So what you do is you see the P for Patreon at the end of my video. You click on it, or you go to the link down below in the description, and there'll be a link there for Patreon, and you can pledge $1 a month, $5 a month, all the way up to $50 a month. And each tier gives you more and more benefits. I figure with the amount of subscribers that I have now, that should help pay for the costs that I'm going through to bring you these videos and to make them better. And so it's just a better way to support me rather than going to my website and making a cash donation. You can just use your credit card and donate $1 a month. And you can quit at any time. You can set a cap on it. You can quit any time. It doesn't matter. And each tier will have more and more benefits. So the more you donate, the more benefits you get. I'm going to be having giveaways, t-shirts, stickers, hats. And the highest tier, if you're a high tier, which is $50 a month, you will receive a chance to come here and work with me in my shop, hands-on. And I'll teach you as much as I can in the amount of time you're here. Come here for a week, 2 weeks, bring your trailer. If you want to bring your trailer, you can bring it out here. We'll work on your trailer. If you want to just help me work on one of my trailers to learn, then come on out and we'll do it. I'll try and schedule people so that they're here at the right time to coincide with whatever part of the project on their trailer that they're on at the time. So we can work out all the details later. But if you're a $50 a month tier, for 6 months, you got to be on there for at least 6 months. Then you can pull out if you want, but you're still eligible to come here and actually spend time with me in my shop, working, using my tools, working on my trailers or your trailer. And I think that's a huge benefit. Plus, you'll get the t-shirts and the stickers and the hats and all the other stuff, the live streaming and all that, that the lower tiers get. So, that's about it for right now. I'm excited to be back to work on the Shasta. And as soon as this is done, you know what's coming next. Back to canned hams. And I'm really excited about that. Back to canned hams. Let's just, one more time, let's walk over here. Yeah, that thing. The main line, the 48 main line. I can't wait to get to work on that one. So, that's next. This shaft is almost done. We'll be done with it pretty quick, and I'll keep you updated on it. And when we get done with it, then we're gonna move to the main line. So with that, we'll see you next time. This is Larry, Mobile Tech, with CannedHamTrailers.com. Happy trails, and happy trailering. We'll see you later.